ചരേമം സൂര്യചന്ദ്രം സാവിവാ പുനർദദതാമ്യത ജാനതാ സംഗമേ മഹീ ജാനതാ സംഗമേ
Forming this mudra, I would like everybody to sit comfortably and close your eyes and mentally prepare yourself for devoting next 2 hours to your own self, to learning and nurturing our heritage. But first, let's remember and thank our gurus who made us what we are.
Let your eyes feel the warmth and slowly, slowly open your eyes. In the world of remixes and merging, we have somewhere forgotten our ancestral roots, and Euphonic Yoga is a merger effort to bring these roots back to the life. Euphonic Yoga, first time ever, combines yoga with the essence of Indian classical music and Indian classical dance. It is a concept that vitalizes and activates the stream of energy system flowing inside the human body, otherwise called the chakra system. The pranic energies flowing through our system is affected by every movement inside and around our body. If the right vibrations are generated in the right combination, it has profound effects on the body, physically, emotionally, and spiritually.
Euphonic Yoga is an amalgamation of music and yoga that finds its roots from Nad Yoga, the ancient Indian text. According to the Vedic philosophy, yoga and music both are part of Nad Vidya. Yoga deals with realization of Anhat Nad, the unstripped sound, extrasensory vibrations of the eternal force of cosmic consciousness. In other words, Anhat means cosmic music. Yoga is an ancient and well-studied, scientifically designed practice. It is not merely a physical exercise, but combination of therapeutic postures that activate certain chakras or energy centers and nadis, energy channels in the body. It is also a journey within. Yoga helps in creating harmony of mind, body, and soul. On the other hand, music pertains to rhythmic flow of ahat na, that is the struck sound that is produced in nature.
The Shastric School of Music discovered musical notes, as we all may be aware of, sa, re, ga, ma, pa, dha, mi. You can look at the table there. So accordingly, from these sounds of nature while they were invented, and the basic classical ragas for activating specific streams of natural powers and was generated. The original ragas of the Indian classical music that is called as the Shastric music are created according to the deep knowledge of harmonious conscience between the seven chakras and the seven swaras. This is why Shastric musical compositions are found to have significant positive effect on the mind-body system and also have the potential to awaken the otherwise dormant energies. This journey of seven musical notes transcends into the world of seven mystical chakras. While classical dance narrates the mood, expression and significance of both performing arts.
Indian classical dance honors the body as sacred temple, the playhouse of the spirit. Kathak and Odissi are two of the eight classical dance forms from Indian classical culture. Is one such graceful art form. Every movement, every mudra and every posture has a spiritual meaning to it. It is interesting to note that many hand mudras used in dance coincide with the hand mudras of yoga. Yoga states that the fingers of our hand represent the Panch Mahabhutas or the five elements. Touching one finger with others in different combinations creates circuits in our body through which energy flows. Such a flow of energy allows the body to gain better circulation of blood, indirectly formulating long-term health benefits.
There is one catch here. You need to answer only in one word.
Okay, what is the one thing that is essential to live a balanced life?
One thing that is essential to live a balanced life. For you?
For me, it's being sensible.
Okay. What is that one thing that must be absolutely do away with to lead a balanced life? One thing which you don't need to lead a balanced life.
Anger.
A very good answer.
Negativity.
So we wanted to know whether you are a positive thinker or a negative thinker. So we got a great answer. What about money? One word for money. Greed.
Power.
Essential.
Power.
Great. And what about love?
Affection. And it must be pocket.
Sorry?
Yes.
Attention. Love, attention.
Okay.
Something new to hear. Okay. So coming back to Euphonic Yoga, what is yoga for you? For you?
Expression maybe.
Expression. What about you?
Yoga is music.
Okay, yeah. Okay. If you hear your breathing or your heartbeat, it's, of course it's a music, yes.
Spirituality. Peace.
Okay. Great. Peace. And what about music?
The state of satisfaction.
State of satisfaction, okay.
The first step to opening your inner temple is to step across the threshold and truly enter the realm of your body. You must fully occupy your temple to open the gateway of divine. The key to entering the body is to embrace the first chakra element, that is earth. This element represents everything solid, representing the mother principle, the original matrix.
Hence, mood means root, origin, essence, Aadhar means the foundation or basis.
The main symbol of Muladhara is an elephant with seven trunks. Energy to rise easily and energize and nourish the
dance is composed of a rich variety of bhangi, the basic poses or movements of nritya found mostly in the Hindu cultures. This dance style mainly follows the three bhang, the three-dimensional body structure. The movement of the hip is a unique dimensional body in Odissi, while such movements are prohibited in other dance forms. One of the typical poses in Odissi is the natwar bhangi, or the three bhang. In Odissi, this is achieved by sharply deflating the hips in one direction, deflating the torso in another, and finally deflating the head in the same direction as the hip.
Let's experience the different styles of jalans in Odissi dance. Meen Dandi.
Oh.
Next we have Manipura Chakra. You move your body, your joints, your breath, your prana. The faster you move, the more heat you generate. This heat is caused friction. So matter and movement combine together to generate the element of third chakra, which is the solar chakra, or we call it as Manipura Chakra. The name Bhujang Asana comes from the Sanskrit word Bhujang, which translates to snake or serpent, and asana meaning posture. Hence it is often referred to as cobra pose, as it reflects the posture of a cobra that has its foot raised.
The next asana is Dhanur Asana. Dhanur Asana has been named after the shape of a body takes by forming it, that of a bow. Dhanu means bow, asana means posture or pose. As Manipura Chakra having fire as its element, these ragas also develop the quantity of fire element and make our personality creative, balanced, closely attentive and spiritual. This chakra is a chakra of jewels in which we find the pearls of clarity, wisdom, self-confidence and well-being. Expand into the midpoint of chakra system. With reaching chakras above and three chakras below. The one root chakra takes you to the exact center of the womb.
Garud means the king of birds. the vehicle of Vishnu. The word is usually rendered into English as eagle.
The next asana is Veerbhadra Asana Variation 3. Veerbhadra, the name of the fierce warrior, the carnation of Shiva, described as having 1,000 heads, 1,000 eyes, and 1,000 feet, wielding 1,000 clubs and wearing the tiger skin. The mood created by the Ragas heads in Kundalini pass through the Ajna Chakra and enter the Sahasra in the limbic area of the brain.
Oh.